اهلا بيكم في كايرو دار. هنكمل ال 100 سؤال او اهم 100 سؤال في ماده البيولوجي. السؤال اللي معانا دلوقتي بيقول give reason for each of the following. The root is positively hydrotrophic. Positive hydrotrophic, that means the root tend towards the side which is containing the water. We understand that the oxygen move at the side that facing water and also at the side that facing the gravity, but move away from the sides that containing the light and also away from the touch. So when the water, when the root exposed to the presence of water from one side only, that means the accumulation of oxygen at the side that facing the water increase, but the high concentration of oxygen in root inhibit the growth of the root cells, but the low concentration at the side that away from the water containing low concentration of oxygen which accelerates the growth of the root cells, so the root tend toward the side which containing the water, so that's called the positive hydrotropic character of the root. So the increasing the amount of water in one side more than the other, that leads to the accumulation of oxygen in the side that facing the water more than that the other side. So the accumulation of the oxygen will inhibit the elongation of the root cells that facing the water, but the low concentration of oxygen elongate the cells at the side away from the water, so that causing the curvature of the water of the root towards the side which containing the water, therefore the root is called the positive hydrotropism. The next question. The nerves have the white bright colors. Nerves are white in color. ليه النيرفز شكلها بيبقى لونها white? That due to the presence of fatty layers that surround the nerve, which is called the epineurum. The epineurum is the outer layer that surrounds the nerve, which is composed of a great number of nerve bundles and neuroglia inside the nerve. So the white matter that surrounds the nerve outside is called the epineurum. The next question. Give reason for some of the nerve axons are surrounded by myelin layer. Understand that the myelin layer is a fatty layer that's created by Schwann cells, and that accelerates the nerve impulse to reach 140 meters per second in the part of the axon which is covered by myelin layer, but reaches 12 meters per second in the parts which is not covered by myelin layer, which is called the Ranvier nodes. يبقى بتيجي في المكان اللي فيه مايلين وتعمل جامبنج من اول المايلين لاخره. واخر المايلين المنطقه اللي فيها الرانفيه نودز دي تبدا تتحرك بشكل بولاريزيشن دي بولاريزيشن ري بولاريزيشن اند سو اون. اوكي؟ ذا نيكست كويستشن. The give reason the stimulation of the nerve obey the all or none law. All or none law. That means if the stimulus is sufficient, the nerve membrane is stimulated. But if the stimulus is insufficient, the nerve membrane is not stimulated. يعني واحنا في الشمس حد جاب شمعة وحطها جنبنا هتنور. النور اللي جاي من الشمعة مش هيأثر خالص تقريبا، مش هنحس بيه في وسط الشمس. وبالتالي هنا اقول the stimulus is insufficient. لو حد جاء جنبي كده او ورايا وحاطط شمعة منورة مش هتزود لي النور. هنا the stimulus is insufficient. طيب لو الدنيا ضلمه وحد ولع شمعه هنا the stimulus is sufficient. طب ولما يبقى the stimulus sufficient the nerve membrane is stimulated to reach the maximum stimulus, and if there is if the stimulus increase the response of the nerve membrane is not increase. يبقى لما يجي يبقى ال stimulus sufficient بيجيب اخر حاجه في response of the membrane. طب ولو ال stimulus increase response is not increase, ده اللي احنا بنقول عليه all or none law. يعني يا الممبرين يجيب اخر ما معاه يا ما يتاثرش خالص وما فيش بعد اخر ما معاه دي حاجه. علشان كده بنقول because the generation of the nerve impulses were not only was not only initiate without the sufficient stimulus. يعني لو ال stimulus ده insufficient, the membrane is not stimulated. طب if it's sufficient, the nerve membrane is stimulated to reach the maximum response. And then any increase in the strength of the stimulus will not increase the response. So the weak stimuli are insufficient to produce and action potential or nerve impulse. يبقى علشان الممبرين يتأثر لازم يبقى الاستيمولس is sufficient. طب ولو sufficient يوصل لماكسيمم response. ولو زاد الاستيمولس مش هيزيد الريسبونس. بعد كده ده اللي بنقول عليه all or none law. The next question. Transmission of nerve impulses across the synapses. Synapses is a site between or the very narrow part between the terminal arborization of one neuron and the dendrites of the next neuron. And the synapses is located between nerve and nerve, or neuron and neuron, neuron and the muscle, neuron and gland. علشان كده نقول لك transmission of nerve impulses due to the presence of vesicles inside the synapse which containing neurochemical transmitter. When the nerve impulses reach the synaptic node, the vesicles secrete chemical transmitter or neurochemical transmitter as acetylcholine and noradrenaline, and it diffuses to the dendrites of the next neuron through the cleft. We understand that when the synaptic vesicles reach the node at the presynaptic membrane, the calcium pump push calcium ions on the vesicle to discharge its contents to allow the acetylcholine to pass through the cleft and reach the postsynaptic membrane where the presence of the receptors which receive the neurochemical transmitter or the acetylcholine and noradrenaline that change the membrane of the postsynaptic or the postsynaptic membrane from the state of polarization into depolarization due to the passage of sodium ions from outside to inside. It changes the state of polarization into depolarization and the impulse passes in the form of polarization, repolarization, depolarization, and so on. The next question. What would happen in each of the following? Exposure of the plant seedlings to light from one side after removing of its growing tip. لو ما قالش after removing of its growing tip, هنقول the stem tend towards the light due to the accumulation of the oxygen at the side away from the light. But the question asks about the exposure of the plant seedling to the light from one side after removing of its growing tip. The removing of growing tip means the action, the auxin or the site of the plant which is responsible for the secretion of the auxin. The absence of auxin means the seedling or the stem is not respond to light. So the seedling will not respond to the light due to the absence of the tip which secretes the auxin which is responsible for the phototropism in this case. The next question. Sensory centers in the occipital lobe are damaged. The occipital lobe containing the vision center. If damage of the occipital lobe is damaged, that means the man will lose the vision sensation because that's the center of vision inside the occipital lobe, which act as a very important part of the two cerebral hemispheres or the brain cortex. The next question. What would happen in each of the following cases? Decrease the secretion of the prolactin hormone. The prolactin hormone is the hormone which is secreted from the adenohypophysis part of the pituitary gland. The prolactin responsible for the secretion of the or stimulate the mammary glands to secrete milk to help the babies to feed on milk or to suck the milk, and also responsible for the secretion of the progesterone hormone. So the absence or the deficiency of the prolactin hormone, that means the secretion of the milk from the mammary gland is decreased, and also the decreasing of the progesterone hormone takes place. The next question. What would happen in each of the following cases? The secretion of the follicle stimulating hormone or FSH hormone is sufficiently decreased in the mature human male. What about the function of the FSH hormone? The FSH hormone in male that responsible for the formation of the seminiferous tubules and its secretions or the spermatozoa, and also responsible for the growth of the and the action of the prostate gland. But the deficiency of the follicle stimulating hormone, that means it will not produce the tests and also or the spermies will not produce from the testes, and also the two testes and the prostate gland may be atrophied. Atrophy يعني ضمور، يبقى هتقل او يحصل ضمور للبروستات جلاند والتستس which may lead to sterility of the male. The next question. Compare between DNA in prokaryotes and DNA in eukaryotes. لما اقول يعني ايه prokaryotic cells؟ يعني cells which are containing or which have no nucleus or have no nuclear membrane. That means the DNA in or the bacteria act as a prokaryotes with the absence of nucleus or nuclear membrane. But in eukaryotes the presence of nucleus. طب نرجع للبروكاريوتس، مفيش نيوكليس، يبقى معنى كده ان ال DNA in the form of circular DNA attached to the plasma membrane، لكن التاني double helix with two free ends، يعني ال two ends بتوع DNA in eukaryotes are not joined together، يعني مش circular. طب ارجع للبروكاريوتس، circular ده ماله؟ ده attached to the plasma membrane، التاني لا جوه النيوكليس. طب والاتاتشمنت بوينت دي مالها؟ هنا the duplication of DNA takes place at the attachment point of the DNA with the plasma membrane. But the replication or duplication of DNA in the case of eukaryotes takes place at any point. مفيش attachment point of plasma membrane لأن هو جوه النيوكليوس في وسط السير، ما بيوصلش للبلازما ممبرين. طب نرجع تاني للـ DNA بتاع البروكاريوتس، نلاقي الـ DNA in prokaryotes is not complex with protein. لكن لما جينا نتكلم عن الدي ان ايه في الكروموسومز عند اليوكاريوت قلنا 50% دي ان ايه و 50% بروتين اللي قلنا عليه هيستون اند نون هيستون في اليوكاريوت، يبقى معنى كده ان البروكاريوت دي ان ايه از نوت كومبلكس ويز بروتين بات ان يوكاريوت از كومبلكس ويز بروتين. الجينوم اوف دي اوف دي بروكاريوت مي كونتيننج وان اور مور سمول سيركولار دي ان ايه ويتش از كولد بلازميد، لكن اليوكاريوتس مش بيبقى عندها بلازمين مع اكسبشنز قليله لليست وكده. طيب لما اجي اشوف الدوبليكيشن اوف ذا دي ان اي، احنا قلنا في البروكاريوتس تيكس بليس ات ذا اتاتشمنت بوينت، في اليوكاريوتس ات اني بوينت. طيب لما نيجي نشوف الجينوم عند البكتيريا اساتذه، نلاقي ان الجينوم او ان الجينوم عند البروكاريوتس all of them or most of them codon, but in eukaryotes 70% codon and 30% non-codon. في نفس الوقت لما اجي اشوف ال RNA polymerase، لما اجي اشوف in prokaryotes، لما اجي اتكلم عن ال RNA polymerase نلاقي ان البروكاريوتس عندها single RNA polymerase to transcribe the mRNA from DNA، لكن عند الايوكاريوتس 3 RNA polymerase to form three kinds of RNA. Transcription in prokaryotes takes a place inside the cytoplasm where the translation takes a place during the transcription. يعني وهو بيعمل ال mRNA من ال DNA في cytoplasm، أول ما يطلع ال 5 prime end من ال mRNA تبدأ عليه الريبوسوم تعمل له translation وهو لسه بيعمل transcription. لكن في الايوكاريوتس the transcription takes a place inside the nucleus. After that the mRNA or the mature mRNA move through the pores of the nuclear membrane to the cytoplasm and in cytoplasm the translation takes a place. لما فاضل لنا نعرف ان الاكزامبل بتاع البروكاريوتس as the bacteria as the E. coli bacteria، لكن الايوكاريوتس as the animal or human cell. يبقى احنا عندنا 10 points act as a comparison between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. My dear students, that's the end of this part of the 100 important question in bio. Thank you very much. Goodbye and good luck.